VIP pre-registration at RGPs just got even better. We here at Channel Fireball and Cascade Games are proud to offer a different exclusive, limited edition pin to our VIPs at each of the 5 Grand Prix we are hosting this year. That's Sacramento, Phoenix, Salt Lake City, Portland, and Los Angeles. If you collect all 5, you can receive the limited edition Planeswalker VIP pin. Don't stress about your GP experience this year with us. Pre-register as a VIP, sleep in, and collect pins.
Hi everyone, this is Paulo on our Theros draft. This pack is extremely underwhelming. I think the best two cards are probably Arisen Informs and Lash of the Whip. Corsair is good, Sentry is good, but I don't want to first pick a double color card. I don't think the rewards were there. I don't actually know which card I like more, the Lash or the Artisan. I think the Artisan is probably a little bit better. So I'm just going to take that. But I could see taking the Lash. I don't think this card is actually very good. It's just decent. Well, this pack is much better than my previous pack. You could take the Wingsuit here, or you could take the Underworld Cerberus. I think I'm going to go with the Cerberus here. I think the payoff is bigger. Wingsuit goes better with Margin, but I don't really care about that. And Cerberus goes well with Argent too. I can copy and get 2 Cerberus. So yeah, I'm just going to take that. And okay. I guess Dauntless Onslaught is the best card here. I think it's better than Hopeful Eidolon, at least the first one. And I really like Scholar Atheris, but I don't want to pick that not knowing what's going to happen. There is a Chimera too. I think Dauntless Onslaught is probably the best card. Though it does not combo very well with December. Okay. I kind of want to take this and just go Black-White. I'm not really sure what to take. I could take the Skullcleaver, I could take the Chosen by Iliad. I think both options are fine. Taking this and hoping to wield the other 2 black-white cards is not horrible. But I guess this card is just very bad. It manages a lot. So I think it's between Chosen by Iliad and Minotaur Skullcleaver. It depends on what I think I'm gonna do with my deck. I think I'm just gonna take Chosen by Iliad here. Okay, we're gonna go black right here. this pack's also very good. There's also a Scholar of Atheros, there's Farkas Mander, which is very good, Nessing Corsair. Dragon Mantle is okay. I think Tamarat is probably better. I mean, it's certainly a better card than anything else. I'm just gonna take it. That's too many rares for me to pass up on. Alright. This is pretty bad. Should I Traveler's Amulet here? Fate Foretold? It's gonna Traveler's Amulet, I guess. Since I'm already all over the place, why not? Okay, there are a lot of those. This card is very, very good, and it's also very good against Black Red. I don't know if I should just take it and try and play Black-White Splashing Red for maybe just a Cerberus. Or I could just take the Skullcleaver and try to smash people. I'll try that. Okay. I'm committed to this color combination, but the problem is that I already passed a lot of, well, I guess the 1-4 and stuff like that. Eh. So I'm probably not going to wheel any of that. Yeah, my deck is pretty much all over the place. It's amazing that I didn't wield a single Scholar of Atheros. There were so many of them. I don't think any deck wants like 5. But this doesn't bode well for me. Because, well, someone else is black-white. Maybe 2 people are black-white. Like, people might have seen the Ashen Rider and thought, oh, that means it should go black-white when it's not actually a great card. But so I don't want to be black-white in this draft. Ooh, Tatsu's. How much Tatsu's worth? Yeah, it's like $4, not worth it. So I can take Erebus Emissary or Wingsuit Rider. Well, right now, I have no colors. I think Erebus Emissary it's more likely that I'll play it. I think it's more likely that I'll be black. Yeah, I'm gonna take that. Alright, this is an insane pack for everyone except for me. There's basically a lot of good cards in blue and in green. Which are definitely the colors I'm not playing. So I could take the Cyclops or the Sip. Or I could just try and splash Sea God's Revenge, but that's probably not gonna happen. Even though I do have two Traveler Hamlet, but that doesn't seem great. I just take the Sip, I guess. Ooh. Maybe I will be. I gotta play a lot of colors. Okay, we're doing it. I have two Traveler's Amulets. I can play four colors. Should have taken Sea God's Revenge, I guess. It's not even that good though in a like control-ish deck. Which hopefully this will be. At least I have a lot of rares. If I get like the Prophet and taps creatures on your opponent's turn, I probably have like every gold rare in the set or something. So how about green for mana fixing? I don't actually want anything else. I might just take a 2-1 for 2, but that's so loose. Play 4 colors in a 2-1 for 2. I don't even know which one I want. Probably the Snarecaster. I think it's more likely that I'll... Should I just try and go 5 colors? Nah, that seems bad. I'll just take this. Maybe I should be green. Like, this is all green cards. I can try it. I mean, the deck's best card is... The best card in my colors would be... I don't even know if I'm going to play those colors, like Titan Strength, or... I'm not going to take Vitus either. I'm not going to take Vitus End, I guess. I'll sort out the mana later. We still have a whole pack for that. I guess Return Phalanx is probably the best card here. Ooh, or Upland Unicorn. Maybe I need a Unicorn. This card is very good if you can attack with it, which I will be able to. I think I need the early game, actually. So, do I have Mnemonic Wall? Probably not. I have Triad of Fates. I don't want to play this, but I don't want to play any of those cards. Should take him to Mnemonic Wall, I guess. She's like, I will not be going green. Or maybe I will. Come on, Elias Presence. Yep.